I know you're home, at home, so just want to stay safe and try to give the best that you can. Well, good morning, kids. I know that you are home as well. Good morning, children, everyone. Well, this is starting with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray.
Thanks, brother.
Good God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feasts kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what from they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please sit.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of the bread and to the prayers. All came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's needs. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to the breaking of the bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their numbers those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting. of Israel say, His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, His mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, His mercy endures forever.
Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith, to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now, for a little while, you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable, even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Who sins you are forgiven them, and who sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. When Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst, and said, "Peace be with you," then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it in my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is Christ, is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning, y'all.
Good morning, Father.
My dear brothers and sisters, this is the second Sunday of Easter. And we celebrate this Sunday as the Divine Mercy Sunday. The readings today, in the Acts of the Apostle, the letter of Saint Paul, Saint Peter, and also the Gospel, we have seen how the mercy of God worked. The Acts of the Apostle, we see how the early church lived together, sharing what they have, showing mercy among them. The letter according to Saint Peter speaks about the mercy of God which is sent Jesus Christ for the salvation of man. In the Gospel passage today, after Easter, all these days we have been meditating upon the appearances of the risen Jesus. And today we have seen Jesus appeared and Thomas was not with them, so he did not believe what the other disciples told him. He wanted to see him. He wanted to touch him. So Jesus has shown mercy towards him. Next time, he invited Thomas to come towards him and touch him. And also, my dear brothers and sisters, the mercy of God we experience in the church through the sacrament of reconciliation. And today, Jesus gave the authority to the disciples to bind and to loose. That is through the sacrament of reconciliation. It is one of the greatest expressions of the mercy of God, the sacrament of reconciliation. As we celebrate the Divine Mercy Sunday today, what is mercy? One day, a mother visited a king and asked for forgiveness towards her son. Her son was a soldier. He committed some mistakes, so the king decided to punish him. So this mother came to the king and asked to show mercy towards her son. And this king said, he deserves no mercy, since he has committed the same mistake again and again. Justice demands death. So she said, I did not ask justice, I ask mercy. And the king said, he does not deserve mercy. And this mother said, if he deserves, it is not mercy. I ask for mercy. So my dear brothers and sisters, what is mercy? Mercy is to give what one does not deserve. To give more than what he deserves. So when Jesus Christ, he gave vision to Sister Faustina, two things were asked. The first one is to pray for the souls, entrust them to the mercy of God. Second, tell the whole world about the mercy of God. Third, within the church, we should give emphasis to the mercy of God. So the church divides the acts of mercy into two groups. The first one is the corporal acts of mercy, and the second one is the spiritual acts of mercy. The corporal acts of mercy are to feed the hungry, to refresh the thirsty, to clothe the naked, to shelter the homeless, to visit the sick, to visit the imprisoned, and to bury the dead. And the spiritual acts of mercy, to instruct the ignorant, to counsel the doubtful, to admonish the sinners, bear wrongs patiently, forgive offenses willingly, comfort the afflicted, pray for the living and the dead. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us show the divine mercy to our beloved brethren, those who are living around us in our family, through these corporal and spiritual acts of mercy. And let us remember what our Lord Jesus Christ instructs us to do. Be merciful as your Heavenly Father is merciful. God bless you. Amen.
Now, my brothers and sisters, let's profess together our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. No. I believe in Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through his all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and death, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of death and the life to what to come. Amen. As humble servants, we offer these petitions on this Divine Mercy Sunday to our loving Father. Today, I would like to pray for the intention of this Mass, that is for Frank and Wanda Wisniewski, Laura and Haldas Kapiski, Teresa Holscher, St. Rose of Lima Community, James and Edith Valisek, and Banda family.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the church and all the clergy be inspired and energized by this holy Easter season, spreading the message of salvation to all the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That God's grace would protect those medical professionals who are treating coronavirus patients. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our children who will soon receive the body and the blood of Christ for the first time continue to patiently wait in eager anticipation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the people of St. Rose be inspired to good works in support of all our neighbors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all the sick and suffering may experience Christ's divine mercy and be healed quickly, especially the Banda family and all who are afflicted with coronavirus, especially Justina Garcia. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all who have left this earth may find an eternal home in the arms of our Heavenly Father, especially all who have succumbed to the coronavirus, especially Diana Martin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. I would like to pray for our community of San Rosalima during these times and for all our communities here in our diocese of Galveston, Houston. And today I would like to ask to bless and pray for, because finally after months and years, I can say that now finally we start during this tough time, but we start a new school building. And we have to deal with many situations, many problems as well, but finally we are. And some of our parishioners, they can see the letter that we sent this last Thursday evening in our Facebook, from the parish, from the school side as well, and from the ECC. So pray for the new school building that really we can really complete. It's probably for the next school year. Let us pray to the Lord. I would like to ask you to bow your head down, please, and in silence, pray for those intentions that we have in our hearts. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please sit. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblation of your people and those who have brought to this community that renew by confession of your name in baptism, they may attain the unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, O Lord. In this time of all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death, by rising, restore our life. Therefore, overcome, we pass with joy, every land, every people, exalting your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we sing together. Sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they become for us the body and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willing to his passion, he took bread and gave you thanks, broken it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given off for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from of it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Given thanks that you have had us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you.
Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Command and for by divine teaching we were to sing. Mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. But only sin. I would like to ask you, because this situation is the time that we cannot receive physically the body of Christ, but we have in every Sunday during these times, we have this ad hoc spiritual communion. So I would like to invite you to read together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come in this spirituality into my heart. I thought you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not to ever be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception in this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We'd like to extend a warm welcome to all of our guests and visitors that are here. And you know, it may be that you've just stumbled upon the St. Rose website or the Facebook, and maybe you're at this liturgy. So we welcome you here, and we ask you to come back. We're here every Sunday at 10 o'clock. The Divine Mercy Chaplet will be in English and in Spanish today at 3 p.m. That's at 3 p.m. here, and it will be on Facebook. And lastly, I would say that one of our most popular events for the children of our parish is summertime VBS. Unfortunately, this program requires much advanced planning, which we are not able to complete due to the COVID-19. As a result of this, we are not going to be able to offer VBS this summer.
And before I finish, I would like to invite everyone, have your friends and more neighbors, more people around your neighborhood or in this city or out of the city, out of Texas or in Texas or in another part of the world. Invite that to join us by online at Facebook or San Rosa Lima. We are so happy to welcome you and be with all of you as well. So, and I would like to express my gratitude. I don't know, I know that you cannot see it, but behind all this technology, there are some people who work so hard. I would express my gratitude to Joe Reyna. He's exactly behind you. You cannot see him, but all the time he's behind all this technology in order to be online all the time. And behind this all the time, we have the musicians. I know that you cannot see them, but you can hear them. So English and Spanish as well, all the time. I want to spread my gratitude to Richard. He's the new coordinator, music director. But in this time is Anthony. Thank you, Anthony, for your time, your talents. And Julie, thank you. Really, I'm sure you have beautiful talent, and I would like to express my gratitude to all of you and all the holy deacons, Deacon Ed, Deacon Larry, Deacon John. He's working and doing different kind of activities, and we have the 12 o'clock mass as well, and Father John as well. Thank you, and all of you as well. Well, and you heard the good news during the Prayer of the Faithful as well. My friends, finally we started the new school. Build it! So now I know in the middle of all this kind of stuff, I thanks be God that we can do it. We have the support of our Archdiocese of Galveston and Houston as well. And you can read, if you want more information, we send the letter, I repeat, the letter by Facebook, the school site as well in Cardinal Corner as well, and the Lisa who represent the ECC as well. We have this new good, very nice good news between all of us. Well, in our repeat, some of the people complain about that all the time. When I finish the mass, I don't say the key words that say specific for San Rosa Lima when I celebrate the mass. Well, I would like to do and say it. And don't feel that those who are not belong to our parish, I know there's something strange. But normally we do it every time when I celebrate the mass, and to be with the kids, the children that they like, and our parishioners as well. We have some special buy to our parishioners, okay? So don't surprise when I give you the blessing and offer the dismiss, I give you something extra, okay? The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Have a wonderful Sunday, and hasta la vista, babies.
Thanks to the Lord, our God and King, has governed us forever. For He is good, He is above all things. Sing praise, sing praise. know.